Now, it's not often that I get excited over the small little UI changes or updates or little things that they added to the SharePoint Admin Center. It's not often, but this is an exception. This one's going to be so nice and not only a time saver, but a stress saver for a lot of admins. Let's get into what this new thing is and how it's going to affect you. So custom scripting, it's one of those things that once in a while you'll come across this, or depending on what you're doing, you may be running into the need to enable custom scripts on a site on a regular basis. What have we always had to do to get this thing turned on? PowerShell. That's right. We've always had to go into PowerShell. We've always had to run a command to enable this thing on a site. And if you like PowerShell, it isn't a big deal. If you don't like PowerShell, if that's one of those things that stresses you out because you're not comfortable in there, you're afraid of running a command to break stuff, I hear all that. I hear all those excuses from people, and they're valid ones. You could forget all of that now, because all you have to do is go into the Admin Center. It's right here. It's really, really nice. Let's just jump straight to the Admin Center, and let me show you where to find this new setting. So here in the Admin Center, all I'm going to do is just click on a particular site. And if you go into settings, here it is, custom scripts. It's right. I mean, all you have to do is click on it and change it to allowed or change it back to blocked. Actually, you don't even have to worry about changing it back to blocked, because as you see, it will automatically revert back in 24 hours. So it will, you can turn it on. You can do the work that you need to do on the site, and then just forget about it. It'll automatically lock back down. Everything will still work, but you won't be able to add anything else to it, which means it's a little bit more secure than it was before. So whether that's, you know, the need to add a web part, or you have a script that's got to be executed and it requires custom scripting to be enabled, it'll be easy for you to do this as an admin. Whether your end users need to do this, or for you, or just you yourself need to do this, it'll be quick to turn this thing on, make all your changes, and then just forget about it. You can switch it back to blocked, but I mean, for 24 hours, I'll save that time and not go back into the Admin Center, and then just go on with my day. It's just easier for me. So it's a really nice quality of life feature. It is interesting that before, with the PowerShell method, it wasn't a 24-hour revert. Now it is. At least through this UI, it is. And so, you know, there's a lot of things that you would do with custom scripting enabled, like access the property bag and on, you know, which are kind of hidden settings or hidden values that you can use as a developer or as an administrator on each particular site. And there's really no other way to do some of these things than through the custom scripting method. So by Microsoft introducing this 24-hour revert, I wonder if their ultimate plan is to completely eliminate the custom scripting option and keep everything very locked down. And if so, what the new methods will be to do some of the things that we currently do through the custom scripting interface or option, not interface, but option. So It does make me wonder what's coming down the road that will change some of this. It almost does look like maybe they're trying to phase this whole thing out. But if so, then why did we get a UI update? UI changes take an extremely long time within Microsoft. It is a lot of red tape to go through. There's a long process to get anything added to the UI. So the fact that they went and added this, I don't know. I'm a little unsure about whether this is going to be around to stay, or this was a kind of a band-aid while they start to phase this thing out. Let me know what you think down in the comments below. Have you been using the PowerShell method to control custom scripting? And are you going to be using the UI now? Are you going to stick with PowerShell? Let me know what you think of this whole update, and let's discuss it in the comments. Now, I made a video recently you may also be interested in. It was about some of the new list templates that were introduced to SharePoint and how we could use JSON formatting to customize those. So if you want to see that, click into this box right here, and I'll see you over there.